by Nani. So when I was in the fifth grade, I remember learning about Mother Teresa. My teacher marveled at her life of service, how she traveled far and wide to help the helpless. And I remember wondering, what's the big deal? This is my Nani's daily routine. My Nani, Dr. Popati Malkani, was the first of generations of pediatricians to come, all inspired by her. She spent her days caring for babies at Calcutta's poorest orphanages, as well as anyone in a 5-mile radius. Studying medicine back in that age made her quite the rebel. What's more, at the age of 26, she set sail across the seven seas to become a gynecologist in the US. She then brought all her siblings over, setting them, each of them up for their own paths to success. She left her mark in the US. One of her patients was so appreciative of her that she named her daughter Popati. So today, there's a 60-year-old African-American Popati somewhere in Chicago. You need to have really made a difference to someone's life for them to want to perpetuate a name like Popati. If you know the Mansukhani Mirchandani clan, you know we're a family of headstrong women. And if you married into it, you probably have scars to prove it. This is how Nani raised us. Strong, independent women before it had a hashtag that made it cool to do so. She herself was known as Turbo, an unstoppable force of energy who could take on any challenge, from surviving cancer twice to my Nana's most elaborate corporate dinners. My Nani has been connecting the world decades before Mark Zuckerberg had the idea of Facebook, but in a much more meaningful way. Thanks to her deep friendships, I have had beds to crash on through my years of globetrotting. She always knew someone who was more than eager to help her family. Also thanks to her, all of Calcutta often knew my exam results before my parents did. If you wonder where my mother got the gift of the gab, well, the apple does not fall far from the tree. Old age took its toll on my Nani, but even as she lost her ability to walk, her ability to hear, as per her convenience, of course, she never lost her grace, always showering blessings on anyone she saw. She was a limitless reservoir of blessings, my personal cheerleader. No matter where I was in the world, no matter how much I thought I may have failed, she was always rooting me on, minus the acrobatics, of course. You can say she's blessing us from wherever she is up there, but I really hope she isn't. She's done her bit, 94 years of it. I hope she's instead chilling with my Nana, knocking back a few whiskeys, and arguing about how stupid my Nana's choice in fruits are. It's hard to lose someone so special, but the last 4 years have been rough for my Nani. It's thanks to the dedication of Moni Didi, Anita Didi, and especially my mom, that my Nani spent the last years enveloped in the same love and care that she had given us our whole lives. So thank you, Mama, for helping her live long enough to witness the birth of a great-grandson, and for me to be able to hug her one last time. I'm leaking. We really appreciate all that you've done for her. You've definitely inherited Nani's best.